Another calibrated Eon. UC Specialist Slate. The Model A's we have in the armory are first class and will respond to any threat on the station. I don't have security. I don't have clearance to know what goes on in there. Losing my brain. I don't have clearance to know what goes on here, but I know well enough that any security breach needs to be eliminated. Given the stakes, I've made it my personal project to bolster their weapon systems. After studying their call stacks, I feel like I can make some improvements in their programming subroutines, too. But when I told the lieutenant, she responded with that grim stare of hers. She reminded me that I need to get approval through the proper channels before modding the machines on my own. Mm-hmm. Makes sense. Clearance code computer. Security station password.
Last one. You know the grill. Kill him.
Duck out of the way. Look at that guy flying up. Look at that. Camera? Fighting vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Bad luck for you. Come
on. This guy's really tough. Are you the boss of this level?
Done.
Well, boss has been eliminated.
Who's next?
Who's fire? Oh wait. Oops.
Got him.
Got him. She destroyed the camera. I guess the cameras are considered hostile, so.
God's sake. Drop some of that rubbish already.
That's credits. If you consider credits rubbish, then give me all your money. Because you'll be the fool that parts with her money. Anything good in here? Keep the helmet. Anything good over there? This place is kind of too big. Decorative pendulum. 184 creds, 217, ship repair fundamentals. Huh. The real trick to spaceship repair is to focus on the immediate and pragmatic. To ask yourself, what can and should I be addressing right now to make my ship flight worthy? Space travel is exceptionally dangerous, we all know this. But focusing on that danger, obsessing over it, helps no one. In fact, thinking about it too much, especially when faced with a malfunctioning ship, can be paralyzing. Just keep it simple, and do whatever needs to be done, even if that means using scrap or salvage to keep yourself afloat. Afloat. I guess. Makes you think of a different kind of ship being afloat. So begins Horace Shan's Ship Repair Fundamentals, the go-to book for spaceship repair throughout the settled systems. Advanced. Should I try it? Advanced isn't as bad as expert. That one's not doable. No, that one neither. Too close together. This one we can do. This one we can do. And that one we can do. Jake and the Eno, I read that. 446 credits. I read part 1 and 2. This whole door, though, is locked with an expert lock. It's not gonna do it. Can we do it? Doesn't fit. Can I do this one? Let's see. No. Yeah. So I can do all the undos if I wanted to. Can't fit that one. Four left. What if we just did the tiny ones first? These look like they could fit, but they're just not far enough apart. And that one's an extra pick thingy. There's too many. Not enough holes and too many pick things. No. Ooh, getting further. That one's not gonna work. We can do that one. And this one. Nice, we get in. Awesome. Okay, we got power packs and spacesuits. Sweet. Some ammo. Sealant. More sealant. Alright, fish workers flashware. Cool, well that's that. Oh, the succulent.
Got my target.
Whoa! Thanks! Thank you for that. Someone else this way? Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, come see.
Oh. I got him. Whoa. Suicidal, these people. Alright. You did a good job with this one.
Find anything useful?
Yes, indeed. Alright, so. There's a lot of stuff here. Count of Monte Cristo. Great Expectations. I've read Neon Gang Culture. I'm not so much sure of Rhapsody on Windy Night. The following is a passage from T.S. Eliot's Rhapsody on a Windy Night, one of the poet's earlier, almost cynical works. I probably read this. The lamp hummed. Regard the moon. Oh, I just read it, actually. I read that very recently. For whatever reason, the title didn't seem familiar. Okay. Do you mind? 265 creds. Enter 10. Advanced Star Roamer, Space Helmet, Space Rogue, Muscle Gear. Glad she just walked off. Ammo. Well, I guess we're okay. We're so worried about that they were gonna kick our butts, and you know, it was a little tough, but it's okay. We survived. Survived to look at notepads. Security station key card. Grendel. People got a lot of snacks. A lot of snacky time at the station. Snacky time at the station. Please make it stop crashing.
Carrying enough clutter there, or should we find some more?
We should find some more. Like this. Took the long way around, didn't I? Let's see. Shotgun shells, okay. They were very, very. Ooh, shock troop space helmet. Those are very valuable shotgun shells. 161 creds, 186. Anything else good? Can't move. Sterile nanotubes. Antimicrobial? I'm not sure if that's a resource or a medical thing. A medical assistance thing. Okay. Was there something back here I wanted to look at? I feel like there's something left. Wait a second, where was that? Oh. I missed him. Okay. I didn't take that. Infantry Alpha. If there's anything else here. Starting to run out of stuff. Sword of Damocles. Calibrated side star. Star Roamer skip pack. I'm surprised I can keep carrying this stuff somehow. Sword of Damocles. I'm not sure if I read this. Damocles Grey looked up into the eyes of the Reptilon High King and grinned. "Well, Boots, I think it's time I made my exit," he quipped. Then, raising his wrist-mounted comm device to his mouth, he said the words he had uttered so many times before. "Let's do it, baby." A second later, Damocles Grey's sleek chromium death ship crashed through the palace's stained glass dome, raining lasers on any lizard man its targeting computers could get a lock on. "It's the sword! Everybody run!" But the High King never got to finish his command because a gaping hole now stood in the space where his mouth used to be, blasted right through by one of the ship's laser beam guns. The sword then came to a hover 2 inches off the ground, right next to Damocles Grey. "That's for Earth, you ugly iguanas," he said as he swung up into the cockpit and closed the canopy. Seconds later, there was no indication Damocles Grey had ever been on the planet Reptilar 3, except for the pile of dead Reptilons left in his wake. The science fiction novel Sword of Damocles was written by former Constellation chair Visola Chen after her retirement, written under the pen name Victoria Star. Although over 1 million copies were printed, very few actually sold, and eventually Chen decided to distribute the book for free. Now Sword of Damocles is something of a pop culture staple, and copies can be found throughout the settled systems. I guess it's something that people might make fun of. Okay.
Eliminate the enemy! Defend the position!
Wow. You are really good with tactics. And I am very sarcastic. Oh, I can use all these? Wait a second. Data access computer. Beta project approvals. Current projects in beta. Svalin, ComSpike, and Tucer. Okay. For all projects not yet in beta, please consult the project lead for more information. Beta project leads. Project lead for Svalin is Dr. Marcia Penberry. ComSpike is led by Dr. Gabriel Vogel. And the Tucer, whatever that is whatever either of those two is Dr. Ji-Hyun Shim. Cool, okay. What about this one? It's the same. They're all identical? Yeah. Oh well. I mean, just put one computer there. Lawgiver. Whoa! No, 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 no. That was pain. Yikes. Huh? More turrets. Gonna open fire. Server room is down here. Oh, thanks. A white hot fragmentation mine. Heal paste. Treats burns and frostbite.
There's a huge difference between being prepared and carrying too much.
I'm taking med packs. Oh, we got another computer. Let's just save here. See if these say the same thing as the others. Projects. Svalin. Okay. Active. Dr. Marsha Penberry, Engineering Bay 2, Lab Number 1. Project Lead and Permissions. Current status. Project Lead is Dr. Marsha Penberry. Project is under the supervision of both Commander Natara and Commander Akande of UC SysDev. Security and Permissions. Rank Security Clearance, Ensign Plus. Additional Security Requirements, Joint Commander Approval. Svalin proposal. The goal of Project UCE-85 Svalin is to create smart shielding designed to offer better efficiency and power economy for larger starships. I want that too. Rather than generate shield power for all modules, the intelligent shielding would divert power on the fly based on predictive algorithms, taking advantage of data rooted in classic Bayesian inference and time series modeling. By calculating a number of high probability factors, such as distance, enemy ship capabilities, and likely targets, the system would anticipate and generate shielding for specific modules before an attack occurs, rather than rely on in-the-moment computations that are too slow to be practical. Benefits: better, more concentrated shielding. Take a drink. Oh, I had one of these on the other page. I forgot this is to switch the page. More efficient energy consumption and increased power supply for other systems. I'm trying to remember where I saw the other one looked up. I didn't hit it. Project approvals. Phase 1 construction approved for Engineering Bay 2. Development assigned to SY920. Project approved. Approving officer, Commander Kibwe. Oh, that's his first name. Someone mentioned Kibwe before, and they didn't recognize the name. I know him as Akande of SysDef. Project UCE-85 received. Oh. Very good. We'll look at Tusa and then the ComSpike. Engineering Base 6, Lab Number 2. Project lead is Dr. Ji-hoon Shim. For all inquiries, information, and clearance, please consult the guide provided to you during orientation. Security and permissions, rank security clearance, lieutenant, additional security requirements, none. Okay. The goal of Project UCA-44-2SIR is to create a guided missile targeting system that offers surgical ballistic damage to enemy spacecrafts. The use case for the system is to debilitate targets without destroying the ships themselves. Benefits: disabling enemy spacecraft without harming systems or crew, allowing for better recovery of resources and prisoners. More efficient use of weapons, increasing overall cost effectiveness. Phase 1 approvals. Phase 1 construction approved for Engineering Base 6. Development assigned to SY920, Project Approve, Approving Officer Commander Victor Dubois. Project UCA-44 received. I'm interested in these two things, but I don't think we can get into the engineering bay. ComSpike. Oh, well, hopefully we can, because this is also an engineering bay. But didn't someone come take it out of engineering and bring it up, someone was saying? Engineering Bay 4, Lab 4. This has a ComSpike proposal. Upgrade security clearance. Current status, project lead is Dr. Gabriel Vogel. All inquiries regarding the ComSpike should be routed through him. All other matters should be directed to Commander Natara or the highest ranking officer on station. Rank security clearance, Ensign Plus. Additional security requirements, code clearance. Note, level 4 clearance should only be accessed with commander approval. Upgrade security clearance. Activating elevator clearance protocols. Authorizing override. Engineering Bay 4 elevator clearance granted. Please report to Dr. Gabriel Vogel for further guidance. Hope I won't have to kill Dr. Vogel. Project lead and permissions. Project lead is Dr. Gabriel Vogel. All inquiries regarding the ComSpike. Did I read this? I think I read this already. Project approvals. Then we'll go on to the other thing. Phase 1 construction approved for Engineering Bay 4. Development assigned to SY920. Project approved. Approving officer Commander Stephen Woods. Project UC86 received. ComSpike proposal. The goal of Project UC86 ComSpike is to create a highly sensitive receiver capable of picking up communication signals and decrypting them on the spot. Signal range would be star system-wide at a minimum 50 AU. The receiver would be strong enough to pick up traces of frequencies potentially weakened by distance, atmosphere, or a gravitational field. Decryption software would be smart enough to both decrypt any signal within nanoseconds and propose any missing or corrupted data. Benefits. Distress signals become easy to locate and interpret. UC security could detect hostile frequencies before they become a threat. Frequency can't be hostile. Hostile embedded messaging could be easily exposed. Communications across the system are greatly increased with fewer delays. Alright, well that's that. And then what's this say now? According to the archive terminals, the ComSpike is being developed in the engineering bay. Indeed. Go to engineering bay 4. So now we get to get in loose one of those. And I guess this says this. I'm gonna save. I guess this says the same thing. Records office computer. Alright, let's look through the rest of this stuff here. $337 creds. I do not want the choco. Centimeat. Records office computer. Data access computer. Alright, let's look at this. Door control interface. Status open. Closed door. No, we don't need to do that. Okay. Keep that as is. Thank you. There's nothing else in here. You know, I was curious. There's baddies that way somewhere. Or goodies. I guess we're the baddies. We're the baddies this time. Yeah, I'm trying to find those two. Well, not. On him, he says. Oh! Dying. Yeah, pretty much. In the butt. Oops. I've got nothing. Tell him. Searching them? Got it.
I'm going to end you!
Gun went flying. The other one's... up here? Pistol whip or whatever the equivalent would be. There's no more enemies. You can turn the music off. Yeah, I was glad we got in there in that one. Checking for any other terminals like really nearby. I missed a page on one of them. Must be way back there somewhere. Oops. Got stuff. In my experience, though, these kind of cupboards usually don't have anything good in them. But sometimes they do.
I think you need to get rid of some of that gear.
I'll shoot you again. That was a digipick. You know we need that. $48 credits. Emergency access computer. Door control interface. Status closed. Open door. Opening door. Done. Thanks for being done. That's my favorite part, when it's done. No, this is where we were. Well, I can look at these other terminals now that I'm actually back here. I think I missed something, that's why. I don't want to miss anything. Let's see. Not that. That one. Did I loot all these guys? I didn't take that. I don't need the hat or the super paste. Check this one. Oh god, the dead person. Ugh. I hate the way her body moves when the thing lifts up. And it's not that one. Alright, so... Right, we're supposed to go back to the engineering area. Transport lifts. So, it only works for Bay 4. I'm gonna check the others just in case. See him get in there. Engineering Bay 2. Three. Denied. There's 4. Oh, is this the one that didn't even try? Yeah, it didn't even try. The card didn't go in, but it said denied. I thought that was weird. I'm curious, though, to check these other lifts. Denied. Denied. Is that denied as well? Yes. And that one works, but that's the one we came up. So, I don't know why I tried it, to tell you the truth. Alright, let's go to 4. Going to save. Nice.
That was a pleasant change of scenery.
Pleasant change of scenery? Think so. So this stuff doesn't work. 3. Locate the ComSpike. It's moving a little, isn't it? Oh, it's just blinking. Denied. I think the other messages interfere with it. That you're currently trespassing, like, override the other one. Static. Right, there was another intercom back there somewhere, right? That we, I forgot to use. Anybody around? Soldiers and stuff? Oh, yeah.